జీఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్ సమావేశం తర్వాత కేంద్ర ఆర్థిక మంత్రి నిర్మలా సీతారామన్ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు ఇప్పుడు ఆ లైవ్ చూద్దాం
which the GOM had recommended at one level after discussion in the committee in the GST council we have brought in changes they are particularly one item which is the furnaces the electric furnaces which are used in the crematoriums the GOM had recommended 12% we after the discussion in the council have brought it down further to 5% then temperature checking equipments the GOM recommended 18% after discussion in the council today we are bringing it down to 5% and the third item which is the ambulances the GOM had recommended at 28 because it has a different connotation to the automobile sector but even then because it's for a limited period and because it's a very enduring asset for the hospitals even with depreciating value nevertheless we thought even ambulances should be brought down so the GOM's recommendation for the ambulance has been 12% then it was felt that the GOM's recommendations has brought in a lot of substantial change many items were at 18 they have been brought down to 5 many items which were at 12 have been brought down to 5 again and therefore there was a lot of substance in the recommendation made by the GOM and as a result I think the council largely agreed to go with the GOM's recommendation subject of course to these three slight tweaking which has happened largely that's about today's GST council's decision I'm sure by the questions that are being asked but that will be asked now we'll be able to explain further if you have anything to ask us largely the list of items I would for your benefit it will also be given as emails or whatever but the list of items are broadly categorized under medicines which had 5 items in it oxygen oxygen generation equipments and related medical devices had 6 items in it testing kits and machines related to testing kits had 2 items under it and other covid related relief materials like pulse oximeters hand sanitizers and so on had 5 items in it so you see that there are 4 categories medicines oxygen oxygen generation equipments testing kits and other machines fourth other covid related relief material so the taxes on these were considered and GOM suggested altering the rates in none of them has the GOM recommended for an increase in the rates existing rates or further bring them down just as a matter of technicality many of the fitment committee's earlier recommendations before forming the GOM have also been studied by the GOM and therefore the viewpoint of the GOM was also put to a thorough discussion in the GOM I am not reading each one of them but that will be distributed so you will be getting a copy of all the items which have been discussed by the GOM which come under the 4 categories thank you
ma'am we will now take some questions please identify yourself and then ask the question number 18
Timsi Raporia from CNBC TV 18 ma'am from when will these reduced rates be applicable and how much of a relief do you think will be extended to the people because since it is kept in mind by keeping these recommendations of reduced rates how much of a benefit do you think will be extended to the people because apart from the medicines the other things how soon will these start trickling down will there be a mechanism to also to check because already stock is available in the pharmacies with the chemists How can that stock be replaced with the new reduced rates?
What exactly is your question? I'm sorry.
Ma'am, when will these reduced rates be applicable from?
Fine.
Notification should be issued maybe by tomorrow day after. So it will be immediately. You can take it. They are being done almost immediately. I didn't get your question. So on that, the GST has already been paid, but whatever they, now the GST rate will be there, that will be a reduced rate.
50 50.
कुछ ट्रेड एसोसिएशनों ने डिमांड करी थी कि जो व्यापारियों की हालत है लॉकडाउन के दौरान राहत दी जाए, तो इस पर कुछ आपका क्या कहना?
आज का एजेंडा में वो नहीं था विषय, आज का एजेंडा वो जीओएम के विषय के ऊपर ही था।
Madam, I just wanted to know whether there was consensus on this, unanimous consensus on this, these decisions. One, two, the Congress had raised a huge UN cry about the fact that they were not part of the GAUM. Was there any discussion on that at the GST?
In the Council, the discussions happened. And when the secretary announced, and I have mentioned these, there have not been any other voice after my speaking. On the question of Congress outside, I don't know. I don't want to comment on what was said outside. In the council, the three Congress ministers said that in future at least, you should consider having us in it, in a GOM. As much as I can say with confidence, the selection into a GOM is never made on party basis. Neither is the exclusion. There are several GOMs. Several ministers are made members of a GOM in which all states are given some representation in one or the other GOM. Neither the inclusion nor the exclusion happens on political party affiliations. It is a GST council consisting of finance ministers, some of them deputy chief ministers, sometimes even a chief minister who come in there.
Number 33.
मैम, वैक्सीन को लेके कुछ फैसला हुआ है कि उस पर क्या रेट अप्लीकेबल होगा, और जितना अब रेट कट किया गया है जो चार कैटेगरीज में करा है, उससे जो है सरकार के ऊपर कितना बर्डन आएगा या लोगों को कितना बेनिफिट होगा वो?
डू यू वांट टू आंसर इट एंड आई विल आल्सो जॉइन इन आंसरिंग।
वैक्सीन पे 5% जीएसटी और वो वही रहेगी। इसमें जो चर्चा का विषय जब हुआ था तो इसमें यह हुआ था कि इसमें केंद्र सरकार ही सारी परचेज कर रही है, 75% कम से कम परचेज कर रही है, उसका जीएसटी भी केंद्र सरकार ही देगी, लेकिन जो जीएसटी का इनकम होगा उसकी 70% शेयरिंग स्टेट्स के साथ होगी, क्योंकि अगर 100 रुपया टैक्स आता है तो 70 रुपया 71 रुपया स्टेट्स को जाएगा और 29 रुपया सेंटर को आएगा। सो उसमें उतना ही रखा गया है और बेसिकली इसमें अब सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट परचेज कर रही है तो काफी विषय इसमें इस तरह से लिए गए थे।
इसलिए कि जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट खरीद रही है 75% और सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट उसमें जीएसटी भी पे कर रही है, मगर जब लोग गवर्नमेंट की हॉस्पिटल के द्वारा सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के सप्लाई जो हो रही है 75% का मुफ्त में दिलाया जा रहा है, जनता के ऊपर उसके असर कुछ भी नहीं होगा। रेट कट मतलब नहीं, ये आइटम्स अलग है। आप वैक्सीनेशन के ऊपर जब प्रश्न पूछ रहे हैं, यही है जवाब कि केंद्र सरकार खरीद रही है और केंद्र सरकार पूरे के पूरे जो जितने भी वो खरीद रही है वो मुफ्त में जनता को दे रही है, इसीलिए उसमें जीएसटी का असर कुछ भी नहीं जनता के पास और जनता के ऊपर लगेगी।
Question is enough now. Abhi, you asked, already asked two. We'll come back to you later if anybody else has a question.
But your point is that money will be given back to, will go back to, when the center is buying, say, for 100 rupees a vaccine and you're paying 5% GST, then states will also get a sizable amount back to their state kitty, right?
It is not sizable amount, Sunil Prabhu. There is a formula for devolution. As per that formula, is collected is first of all divided 50-50. Then from the center's portion of 50 also, a certain amount goes to these states, resulting in approximately 71 rupees for every 100 rupees collected will be with the states, approximately.
But just to emphasize the point which FM had mentioned in the answer to that question is that as far as people are concerned who are coming to get their inoculation done, it is tax-free. So it's not an issue with the people. So they are not paying any tax on it. They are not paying any cost of the vaccine also. It's free for them.